Oh my gosh, it's everywhere. I can't seem to get this plant to stop growing. I mean, it grows almost overnight. Someone gifted me this plant a while back, saying that it had beautiful flowers and it produced a lot of fertility for the garden, built soil really well. But they failed to tell me how much it would just take over. It has become the number one nuisance plant on my property. And a lot of people know it around here as Mexican sunflower. Its Latin name is Tithonia Diversifolia. And it is the worst plant I ever planted on my homestead. Now, I know there's a lot of people out there raving about this plant, and for good reason. It creates a massive amount of biomass. This plant grows super quick. Within a month, you have fresh greens ready to chop and to use as a fertilizer. And in fact, this plant produces what some say a better fertilizer than even cow manure. It has higher nitrogen, higher potassium, and higher phosphorus content than cow manure, but still it's really balanced, making it a really great vegan manure, if you will. Bees seem to flock to this plant. Every time it's in flower, bees are all over it. This plant is known to be pretty medicinal in some cultures. They have used the leaves and flowers to make medicines that help with fever and diarrhea and nausea. The woody stems of this plant can even be used as an awesome fire starter. That's one of the ways I found to get rid of this plant, is to just burn it. And when the woody stems dry up, it burns up super quick. It is like fresh tinder thrown in the fire. It gets any bonfire going. And in fact, the long straight woody sticks can be used as a drill in a bow drill for making friction fire. There's even claims that this plant is good to use as animal forage. Have I seen my animals go for this plant, eat it? No. I just got sheep. They are not interested in it at all, even though people have said their sheep have eaten this plant. There's word out that chickens will eat this plant, and I have not seen them interested in touching this plant. Perhaps maybe seeds from the flowers. There must be a lot more here that they actually want to eat. This plant is probably way down on their list. But even with all of those benefits, does it make up for the drawbacks? This plant for me has been nothing but a waste of my time. Every month I spend hours chopping it back and making sure it doesn't get too woody so that it won't re-sprout and grow somewhere else. And in fact, I don't always get to all that pruning. Sometimes I'm just too busy and it gets to flower and I gotta figure out what to do with all that woody biomass that will sprout wherever I put it. One good thing this plant has going for it is it's really easy to cut. You can break it with your hands or you can chop it with one smooth swipe with a machete. It's just, do you want to do that all the time, every month, to create biomass? Because for me, I'd rather choose another plant that is a much easier to manage. I have ice cream bean here that I don't have to cut as regularly, but produces a ton of biomass. Pigeon pea is another plant that produces a lot of biomass, fixes nitrogen in the soil, and is a great fertilizer chop and drop plant for your garden. So why go through the energy of having to manage a plant that doesn't seem like it wants to be managed? Overnight it grows, and regularly you're out there having to chop it up. And unless you're a full-time homesteader, you never leave your property, and you don't mind getting out there on clockwork to manage this plant, I highly recommend that you think twice about planting this Mexican sunflower, because you might just regret it the way that I did. This plant should come with instructions. You see, when I first got this plant, nobody told me about it. They didn't say, don't let it get to its woody stage. They didn't say, don't drop it on the ground when it's at that stage or you'll just have a million more plants. No, I had to learn it out the hard way. And I have been dealing with it for a long time now, trying to get this plant under control. It's starting to happen. I found ways to do it naturally. I chop it back a bunch. I hack at the woody stems as much as I can, and eventually they just kind of rot out and you can just yank them out of the ground. But it does take some time, it does take some constant management to be able to make that happen. And I'm still not there yet. I have plants all over the place that are sprouting up where I didn't put them, or I just haven't been able to get to, and now they're huge, tall, woody stem plants that I'm just afraid are just gonna sprout all over the place. In fact, I've had them sprout across the street from my place. I don't even know how that happened. I didn't put any branches over there, but there they are. It must be spreading by seed, right? So be careful. Even though people are recommending this plant, it can be highly invasive. It's most invasive between 500 and 1500 feet here in Hawaii, where it's a little bit wetter and a little bit cooler, where the plant doesn't have a chance to really dry out as it does near the coast. And it's also not so high up that it's just too cold for it. But right here where I live just seems to be the prime zone that this plant just wants to spread like a noxious weed. So I have this plant popping up all over, on the other side of my fences, on the inside of my fences, in places I didn't want it at all, in places I never even imagined it popping up. It just seems to show up everywhere. Is that what you want to have happen on your homestead? For me, uh-uh. So I hope you take these words of advice, that you think twice about planting this plant. This has been the worst plant I planted on my homestead, but I'm trying to make the best of it. If you happen to love this plant and think I'm completely wrong, tell me otherwise in the comment section down below. And if you agree, also let your fellow homesteaders know that this plant really hasn't worked out great for you. I hope you liked watching this video. If you've been with me for a while, you've noticed that I have been posting a little less. I've been enjoying just working in the garden without having a camera there and just actually getting things done, because it does take time to shoot and produce and make these videos that sometimes I just want to bust out a project, right? So just please bear with me. I still want to produce more videos and get more content out for y'all. And it's gonna happen, guys. I'm gonna get back into it. So till next time, everyone, plant that finger on the like button, and ahui ho.